Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how to find the total number of hosts per a network or per subnet, also the maximum number of subnets in a very easy way that you may not have seen before. Before we get started, I would like to show you a different types of subnet mask. And the reason is we solve all the questions related to the subnetting using subnet mask. So subnet mask is the key to find the answer for any subnetting question. Here we have the first type of subnet mask, which is called CIDR notation, or sometimes they call shorthand. It is IP address and a number. So after IP address we get a slash, then a number, this number called a CIDR. The other type is decimal, which is very common for everybody, 255, 255 something. And the third type is a binary. A binary is written like 1 or 0. Basically, each IP address or subnet mask consists of 4 octets, and each octet consists of 8 bits. And these bits are representing a number. Starting from the left, the first one is 128, 64, 32. The addition of these numbers, you get 255. So this 255 means all the bits in the first octet are on. So let's work on the second octet and make two of them on. As you see, the first two are on, which means the 128 and 64. So the addition or the sum of these two numbers is 192. So the subnet mask becomes 255.192.0.0. And the CIDR will become 10 because we have 10 bits are on in the subnet mask. So anytime you have a subnet mask as a decimal format in your question, you have to convert it to a binary format in order to find the CIDR notation from it. So now let's find the total number of hosts per a network. Regardless what IP address classes you have, you can use this general equation or formula for any type of IP address to find the host per network. So the total number of hosts equals to number 2 power to number of host bits minus 2. And the number of host bits equals to 32 minus the CIDR notation. Let me show you an example, 192.168/26. The 26 is the CIDR notation or shorthand. So 32 minus 26 equals 6. So 2 power 6 minus 2 equals 62 hosts. This way we were able to find the number of hosts in this network. The second example is 172, which is means this is the class B, and the CIDR is 30. So 32 minus 30 equals 2. So 2 power 2 minus 2 equals 2 hosts per this network. So as I said, regardless what IP address classes you have, you can use this way. Any CIDR notation you have, minus 32, you get a number, and this number will be used to power number 2, and then minus 2 you get the host that you have in that network. And this is the third example for class A. As you see, no difference, 32 minus 12 you get 20, 2 power 20 minus 2 you get this host per this network. And now let's find the total number of subnets. As I said, for finding the maximum number of subnets, you need to know the class of the IP address. In class A, the first octet are all on, which means 8 bits are on. So we have 8 bits. And in class B, we have 2 octets all are on, which means we have 16 bits. And in class C, we have 24 bits. So if you have class A, so the equation will be 2 power CIDR notation minus 8. But in class B, you have to minus 16. And in class C, you have minus 24. Let me show you an example how we find this. So if you have class A, how you find the total subnet per network? But before that, how you know you have class A? So if you want to know what class you have to look at the first octet of the IP address. If you have 126 means you have class A. So for example, 16 is in this range, so means that we have class A. For this, we have a general rule. So maximum subnets equals 2 power network bits. How you find network bits? The network bits is equal CIDR notation minus 8. So in class A, whenever you have class A, as I mentioned, you get the CIDR notation minus 8. So let me show you in an example. So we have 10.001 and the CIDR notation is 12. 12 minus 8 equals 4. So 2 power 4 equals 16 subnets. Another example, 23. 23 minus 8 equals 15. So 2 power 15 means you have 32,768 subnets. So this is for class A. What if you have class B? How you know you have class B? That you will look at the first octet. If it is one of the number between 128 to 191, it means you have class B. The same way, you have general equation maximum subnets equals to 2 power network bits. How you find the network bits? This time, the CIDR notation will be minus 16 instead of 8. So in class A, you minus 8, but in class B, minus 16. Let me show you an example. 16 minus 16 equals 0. So 2 power 0 equals 1 subnet. So for this IP address and this CIDR notation, you have 1 subnet. So we have the second example. 130 means you have class B because this number is between 128 and 191. And the CIDR notation minus 16 equals 7. So 2 power 7 equals 128 subnets. So the only difference between class A and class B is minus 16 and minus 8. For class C, how you know you have class C? First octet in the IP address should be between 192 to 223. We have the general rule, subnets equals 2 power network bits. The network bits is come from the CIDR notation minus 24. In this example, we have class C because the IP address started with 192 and the CIDR notation minus 24 equals 2. So 2 power 2 equals 4 subnets in this network. This is another example. 192 is belong class C and we have a CIDR notation 30 minus 24 equals 6. So 2 power 6 means you have 64 subnets. This way we were able to find the total subnet and total host in a network. I hope this video was useful for everybody. See you in my next video.